Hi. In this video, I'm going to introduce you to JavaDoc. JavaDoc is a documentation generator from Sun. It generates API documentation in HTML format. The doc comments format that is used in JavaDoc is the de facto industry standard for Java documentation. It is used to document classes as well as their members. Here you can see an example. Traditionally, we had two kinds of comments, the block comment and the inline comment. Here we have a JavaDoc comment. Notice the second star right at the opening. Let's talk about the structure of a JavaDoc comment. So it's embedded in the slash star star, closes with a star slash. First paragraph is typically a general description. Then we have tags that label and classify the description. For example, param for parameters of a method, return for the return value of a method, throws for exceptions that might be thrown, author to document who wrote that particular class or interface. Importantly, JavaDocs are placed immediately before the code that they are documenting. Let's look at an example. We start with an optional general description first. There are tags that label special types of information. And my JavaDoc needs to be placed right before the class that it is describing. Second example. Once again, we start with a description here. We have tags that label special types of information. And the JavaDoc precedes my method, so it's placed immediately above the method declaration. Why should we use JavaDoc? There are a couple of good reasons. It minimizes the effort of creating a documentation from the developer point of view. This is because of the proximity of the documentation and the code implementation. It makes it easier to keep the documentation up to date, easier for the software developer to update the documentation right when a method or a class is modified, easier to distribute the updated new documentation because it is online via HTML, so all that needs to be done is it needs to be posted and everybody can access the latest documentation. It makes using third-party classes easier because everything is documented in a similar way. People get used to the structure of JavaDoc, and that makes it easier to find the information that we need. An additional nice feature is that JavaDoc allows us to include hyperlinks to related documents. So at this point, I want to look at an example. Here I have a class point that I prepared for our demo. Point represents a point on the Cartesian coordinate system. So we have an X and a Y. Notice both my fields are final. I only have getters, no setters, because I made my point immutable. There is a parameterized constructor to initialize my fields. Distance that calculates the distance between my point and some other point. And a toString method that I'm overriding here. And it's the typical format, my x and y in parentheses, comma separated. I want to create an instance of my point. And I just say point p1 is a new point. And if I check my different choices, I can go on point here. That looks like my point, and nothing happens. Here I have constructs and initializes a point at a specified x, y location. I would like to have the same type of documentation to go with my point. So I'm going to add a JavaDoc. Right above my constructor, I'm going to write a JavaDoc here. And Eclipse provides me already with my tags for the parameters. But first I want to have a general description. So it says constructs and initializes a point on position x, y. And so here I can see this is my x coordinate and this is my y coordinate. Let's go back to my point app. Now when I say what are my point options and I'm clicking here, it gives me the very description that I just added in my JavaDoc. It says constructs and initializes a point on position x, y. My parameters are x and y. This is my x coordinate, this is my y coordinate. So let's create this point. I'm going to pass a 2 for an x, a 3 for a y. Notice how we get helpful hints here. Let's see, I want to have a second point. And if I click on point, there's no JavaDoc available. If I would go to a point from the Java API, yes, there is type information. We created a JavaDoc for the constructor, but not for the class itself yet. If I want to have information as a declared type, I need to add a JavaDoc above my class. We're going to do this right here. So I'm going to start with some general description. A point represents a point in a Cartesian coordinate system, and points are immutable. They cannot be changed once they have been created. Let's try that out. I'm going back to my point app. As I declare my point, it gives me already information about my point that represents a point in a Cartesian coordinate system. So I finish my second point. My second point is a new point on position 5 and 7. Now I'm going to call the distance method. I want to calculate P1 distance, and if I want to know more about this method and I click on it, no information provided because we haven't written the JavaDoc for the method yet. We're going to do that right now. I'm going back to my point class. I'm going to add some information right above my distance method. Here, my JavaDoc, some general description. It calculates the distance between this point and another point that was passed as an argument. And so here my parameter is called other. This is the point to calculate the distance from. And I'm going back to my point app. I'm looking at distance and it provides the very information I just specified in my JavaDoc. I'm completing the distance, I'm calculating to my distance to point 2, and I wrap it in a print statement so we can actually see the result. System out printf, and I just say distance between point 1 and point 2 is a floating point. Point 1, point 2, and my actual distance. Let's run that. Move that up a little bit. Distance between 2, 3 and 5, 7 is 5.0. That looks good.